click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have talked about the earliest concept of acid and base, and now we are going to talk about the Lowry Bronsted concept of acid and base. So according to them, what is acid and what is base? Let us talk about it. So now, according to the theory, an acid is defined as a substance which donates a proton, that is H plus ion, to the other substance. And the base is a substance which accepts a proton from the another substance. So basically this is the one that it is dealing with, the proton accepting as a proton donating. So the one which donates proton are to be called as an acid according to this theory, and the substance which accepts the proton is called to be, that is, a base. So let me give an example in this case so that we could understand it in a better way. Suppose if we have HCl that has been reacted with, suppose, H2. So in this case, because HCl has the capacity to donate its ion and to donate its ion in the form of H plus ion. So that's the reason that this HCl will donate its H plus ion to the H2O. So that this HCl will donate its ion to H2O so as to form, that is, H3O plus. And as here we could see that only thing that has been left out is Cl minus. So because HCl is the one that has donated its proton to a particular substance, and that substance is H2O, that's the reason that HCl is called to be acid. But in terms of Lowry Bronsted, and since H2O is the one which has accepted that proton, so therefore this H2O is called to be base. So this is what we have defined acid and base. But there is also another term that to which we could say that the base can be defined in such a way. But let me tell you that this kind of reaction that it happens, it has a capacity to form, that is, to go into a reversible reaction also, because this is the hydronium ion that has been produced, and this hydronium ion being an acid or being a base, it was not being explained by Arrhenius theory, but this indicates that it can act like acid and base. So we are going to talk about this later on, but let us move on with another example that I want to do showcase, and that is basically, suppose if we have represented, that is, NH3, and this NH3 is being reacted with, suppose, water. So in this case, what will happen is, obviously we could see that the one which accepts the proton is called to be base, and the one which donates the proton is called to be acid. But when NH3 has been reacted with, that is, H2O, it has been found that this NH3 is the one that will accept the proton so as to form, that is, NH4 plus, while the remaining part that has been left out is basically, that is, OH minus. But this reaction is again, we could say that this could be represented in a reversible direction. So in this case, because of the NH3, that is, the ammonia have accepted the proton and so as to form NH4 plus, so that's the reason that NH3 has been called to be base according to the Lowry Bronsted theory. And since H2 in this case has been capable to donate its proton to the NH3, that's the reason in this case it is acting like a acid. So therefore, we could say that according to the theory of Lowry Bronsted, we could say that this is acid, whether this is base, depending on the proton donation or depending on the proton accepting. And this is what I wanted to explain. But there are also few terms that I wanted to explain you, and that is because since it is a reversible reaction that we could see over here. And so that's the reason that among this, if suppose H3O plus has donated its proton to Cl, then this will become, that is, HCl. So now in this case, basically H3O has been acting like acid, while Cl is the one that has been accepting the H plus ion, so therefore in this case it would be acting like a base, that is, the Cl minus will be acting like a base. So that is the reason that we are going to talk about a new term, and those terms are, that is, conjugate acid and conjugate base. So what is conjugate acid and what is conjugate base? Let us talk about this thing. So let us talk about the first one, that is, it is formed when a Lowry Bronsted base accepts a proton forming an acid. While talking about the next one, that is, for a conjugated base. It is formed when a Lowry Bronsted acid donates a proton, forming a base. So what is this two difference? Let us talk about it with the help of an example, and then we will clear these concepts. And this is very important to understand, that is, what is conjugated acid and what is conjugate base. So I'll take the example the same as it is, but it would be very much simple to understand. That is, suppose if I am taking an example like HCl, and it has been reacted with, suppose, water. And so since this is a reversible reaction, that suppose it occurs over here, so that has to form, that is, hydronium ion, that is H3O plus and Cl minus. So in this case, if we observe that the Cl, which is basically acting like a base, how? Because it will try to accept the proton or the H plus ion, so as to form HCl. So if we go through the first, that is, concept, that is conjugated acid, so we could see that is, it is formed when a Lowry Bronsted base accepts a proton, forming an acid. So therefore, in this case, we could say that according to Lowry Bronsted, the substance which accepts H plus ion is called to be base. So that's the reason that Cl minus ion will accept this hydrogen atom or hydrogen ion, so as to form that is HCl. So that is the reason that we could see that this Cl has the capacity to absorb or to take the H plus ion. So that is the reason it has been acting like a base. While this H3O plus, it has a capacity to, that is, donate its H plus ion, so therefore it is acting like acid. But meanwhile, if you are talking about this HCl, even this HCl has the capacity to donate its H plus ion. Again, this will be called as acid, and this will be called as, obviously, because this will accept this H plus ion and so as to form, that is, H3O plus, and that's the reason it is called to be base. So in this case, we could see that this base has been formed because of the acid, that is HCl, and that's the reason that if H has been removed from this HCl, then we could see a base has been formed. So therefore, we could say that this base, or this is basically the conjugated base for the acid HCl. And talking about this acid, so this acid, if it donates its H plus ion to Cl, so therefore it could form, that is, base like H2, or it is forming H2. So that is the reason that we could say that H2 is the conjugated base for the acid H3O plus. So that's the reason, suppose if we recall the definition of what is conjugated acid and conjugate base, we'll get to know that is, it is formed, that is, the conjugated acid is formed when a Lowry Bronsted base accepts a proton, forming an acid. So that is the reason that, or we could also consider for the conjugated base, that it is formed when a Lowry Bronsted acid, that is, donates a proton, forming a base. So that's the reason that if we see that this H3O plus, this will donate its proton, and so as to form a base. So that's the reason that this base is basically known as the conjugated base for the acid, this one. While talking about the Cl minus ion, this Cl minus ion will accept the H plus ion, so as to form HCl. In this case, that's the reason that Cl minus is the conjugated base for the acid, HCl. So now, therefore, we could write this as, this is, suppose if this is acid 1, then we could say that this is the base that has been formed. So therefore, I could name it as 1. And if this is the base that we have, so therefore I will name it as base 2, and because of which the acid 2 has been formed. So therefore they are conjugated to each other, that is, this is conjugated to this base. So therefore we could say that HCl along with this Cl minus, they both are acid base pair, conjugated acid base pair. By talking about this H2O and this H3O plus is basically conjugated acid base pair also. So if you observe this two, that is, if I'm talking about HCl and that of that is Cl minus, so there is a difference of H plus ion, or there is a difference of protons. That's the reason that this two are basically known as the conjugated acid base pair. While talking about this H2O along with that of this H3O plus, even this will have a difference of the protons. So that is the reason that even this are to be called as conjugated acid base pair. So that's it that I wanted to explain you about the Lowry Bronsted theory, and this is it. So even this has a advantage that we could say that H3O plus is acting like acid, but this was not been explained by that of Arrhenius theory. So it has an advantage compared to that one. Thank you, friends, for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you have understood this video very clearly. And I hope you share this video with your friends. And yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel.